This is a new but a really old magic trick. Gentleman who I bought a lot of stuff off of passed away. This was one of his favorite tricks. Problem was, when I went to get it, it had no instructions. So I've had it for about a year. I asked his widow and the son who used to help him, I said, "So how does it work?" And he said, "Oh, I don't know, but it was really, really good every time he did it." So I prayed and I thought about it, and I knew it was supposed to be a washing machine. And since we were talking about clothes today, our spiritual clothes, I was like, "Lord, I really need this trick. Can you show me how to do it?" And by golly, God answered prayers. So I think I figured it out. What's the most frustrating thing when you wash? Socks, right? Two go in. Do two ever come out?
No.
Well, I need some help. Okay, so you two, you need to come up here. Well, this is my washing machine, and this looks like one of those old-time, come on, Ashley, get up here. This looks like one of those old-time washing machines, doesn't it? And, well, they wouldn't know, but they won't know this, but. Okay, so it's an empty box, right? And we are going to put, I'm going to let you each put a sock in. And since this is the way they look at our house, no two match, I thought that was fitting. So we're going to put the lid on, and we're going to do, well, we probably need to put some soap in, right? So we'll pretend to put some soap in. And then I want you to give it a turn. Now, the old ringer washers, you remember those? Okay, so you're going to just really, really wash that up pretty good there. All right. I think they're pretty clean. You don't think so? Well, I don't know. Let's see here. Let's see. What have we got? Well, the problem is what usually happens with most washing machines. Anybody else have that problem? Yeah. I keep saying that I haven't gained any weight. The washer machine just keeps shrinking all my clothes. Okay, so that's a problem. They shrink. Now, I'm going to let you go ahead. We still don't have anything in the box. So I want you to go ahead and put them back in. So, and this is what you usually do, right? When you don't want to put stuff away or if it, something's gone wrong, we'll just throw it back in the... We'll throw it back here in the washing machine for the next person. So we're going to let you wash them up again. You give it a turn. No, that's all right. You give it a turn. You shrunk them, so she shrunk them. Now you give it to me. That's about the kind of effort I get with laundry. Okay, we're talking about spiritual clothes today. Do you know what that is? You're talking about your shirt? Did you listen to the scripture? Mm-hmm. What was it talking about? It said, clothe yourself in what? What were we supposed to cast off? What were we supposed to take off? It was greed and anger and idolatry and all that nasty stuff, right? Let's see. If we don't take that off, what happens to our clothes? Well, they're holy, but it's the wrong kind of holy, isn't it? Yeah, that's what sin looks like in our life, doesn't it? Is it pure? Is it spotless? Yeah, it's all chewed up, it's gnarled up. Sometimes that's what can happen to our laundry too, if we don't watch out what we put it in with. Well, you know, in Colossians, okay, we're going to go ahead and put this back in here. I want you to, can you dump it back in there? Colossians said that we're supposed to cast off everything that is unholy, everything that would cause us to sin. Why don't you give it another turn? Let's wash it again. Let's see, you shrunk it and then I got holy. Well, you know what? The good thing is, though, Jesus said, clothe yourself with what? With Him. We're supposed to clothe ourselves with Christ. Because when He dies, anything. And even, you know, when things don't match and things just don't work out, even when we put them in, guess what? When we're clothed with Christ, we're no longer ourselves, but we put Him on, right? And we can't get rid of Him, can we? Because He's part of us. Right there. You remember the song that we just sang? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? I like this sock because it reminds me of that, because the red is the color of what? Blood, that's right. And so when we wear something like that, it's a reminder that we have been cleansed and we have been saved because of Him. Well, we're going to talk about some other kind of clothing today. We're going to talk about the armor of God. Now see, I still don't have anything in there, do I? Well, we'll put that in there. Let's hope next time we do laundry that we don't goof that one up. But we're going to talk about the armor of God. And we've talked a lot. You guys know about the armor. I was waiting for my other two here because I knew he was going to talk about Ninja Turtles again. We're going to get a little more into that protective armor. But we're going to talk about that in the sermon. So, but what I want you to remember is, even though that we come to God with our soiled rags, our holy rags, God tells us to cast off those and to put on Him and the things that are good, which was what? Peace, patience, kindness, love. Right? I'm sure it ends with me.